Hi everyone, a very good morning to all of you. I hope you all are doing good and preparing well for the upcoming examinations. I am Gulabsa, your mentor for Finance Current Affairs, and I welcome you once again to another session of RBI 247, whereby today we are going to talk about three very important news articles, and these are more important from the conceptual understanding aur yahan se short questions aane ke bhi chances hote hain. Theek hai? But before starting with the session, if you have still not downloaded the app, you can do so. Agar aapko past year papers chahiye, unke analysis chahiye, aur ek jagah pe chahiye, for that case, you can make use of this app. You will get all the consolidated previous year papers at one place. So let's get started with the very first news. That is, SEBI has recently released certain uniform format for over-the-counter trades in non-convertible securities. अब ये जो न्यूज आर्टिकल है यहाँ पे दो बहुत ही इंपॉर्टेंट टर्म्स हैं. द फर्स्ट इंपॉर्टेंट टर्म इज ओटीसी. सबसे पहले हमें समझना पड़ेगा कि ओवर द काउंटर ट्रेड्स क्या होते हैं, एंड सेकंड टर्म इज नॉन कन्वर्टेबल सिक्योरिटीज. सो व्हाट आर दिस एनसीएस. सो बिफोर मूविंग फॉरवर्ड विद द वेरी न्यूज की रिसेंट में क्या हुआ है, व्हाट इज द न्यूज दैट सेबी हैज कम अप, लेट्स फर्स्ट अंडरस्टैंड दिस टू इम्पॉर्टेंट कंसेप्ट और टर्म्स. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल टॉकिंग अबाउट ओवर द काउंटर ट्रेड्स, तो देखो दो तरीके के होते हैं. द फर्स्ट इज द स्टैंडर्डाइज्ड वे ऑफ ट्रेडिंग और बाइंग एंड सेलिंग ऑफ सिक्योरिटीज, दैट इज डन ऑन द एक्सचेंजेस सच एज द बीएससी एज वेल एज एनएससी. दीज आर स्टैंडर्डाइज्ड एंड देर इज अ प्लेटफॉर्म अवेलेबल वेयर बाय पार्टीज कम टूगेदर, देर इज अ प्राइस कोटेड एंड दैट प्राइस इज नोन टू ऑल द पार्टिसिपेंट्स, एंड देन एक्सचेंज हैपन्स ओवर दिस standardized electronic platform. However, in the case of over the counter ke case mein kya hota hai, these are more non standardized or customized way of trading, buying and selling of securities, whereby apart from these two parties between whom the transaction takes place, no one knows about the prices at which the trade is taking place. To agar suppose there is a party one, so this is a buyer who wants to purchase certain share, or that this person can even sell the shares. For example, if the person wants to purchase certain share, then he can go through the broker or the dealer route. So broker dealer se wo khareed sakta hai, and the broker or the dealer will be the person who will be making use of the broker trading platform in order to execute this contract. So this is known as the OTC or over the counter ट्रेड, जहां पे दो लोग आते हैं एंड देन द प्राइस इज डिसाइडेड बिटवीन दीज टू पर्सन एंड ट्रेड हैपेंस, एंड हियर देयर इज नो प्रेजेंस ऑफ एनी काइंड ऑफ फिजिकल लोकेशन. ओवर द काउंटर ट्रेड आपको समझ आ गया होगा. एक और चीज आपको समझना पड़ेगा, दैट देयर इज अ वेरी बिग रोल ऑफ दिस ब्रोकर्स एंड डीलर्स. ब्रोकर्स डीलर्स, अब डीलर्स कौन होते हैं, डीलर्स आर ऑल्सो नोन एज मार्केट मेकर्स. इनको हम MM बोलते हैं फाइनेंस में, दैट इज मार्केट मेकर्स, बिकॉज दे हैव अ लॉट ऑफ बोथ बाय एज वेल एज सेल पोजीशन. अगर मुझे सेल करना है देन आई शुड हैव अ काउंटर पार्टी, दिस डीलर विल एक्ट एज द काउंटर पार्टी, ही विल बी रेडी टू बाय दोज शेयर्स और दोज सिक्योरिटीज फ्रॉम मी. इफ आई वॉन्ट टू purchase certain, then he should be readily available with the shares as a seller, so that I can purchase those securities from that person. So yahan pe inki role badh jati hai, there is no physical location and there is a customized way of trading. Suppose buyer one hai, buyer one can trade with this dealer, buyer two can trade with some other participant. To aise chalta hai over the counter trade. Now since we are clear with over the counter trades, now let's understand the other important term, that is NCS, non convertible securities. Non convertible ka matlab hota hai these securities cannot be converted into any kind of equity shares of the company, and therefore such securities includes items or financial instruments such as debt securities, which includes payment of fixed interest as well as the repayment of the principal amount. Then we have the non-convertible redeemable preference shares. So these are preference shares which are not converted into any kind of equity shares, and these are redeemable. That is, you can redeem after the expiry of a certain period. Apart from that, we have perpetual नॉन क्यूमुलेटिव प्रेफरेंस शेयर्स. परपेचुअल का मतलब लाइफ टाइम तक प्रेफरेंस शेयर्स रहेगा, बट दिस इज नॉन क्यूमुलेटिव. नॉन क्यूमुलेटिव का मतलब होता है द डिविडेंड दैट इज टू बी पेड ऑन सच प्रेफरेंस शेयर्स इज नॉन क्यूमुलेटिव इन नेचर. दैट इज कई बार प्रेफरेंस शेयर्स पे क्या होता है, डिविडेंड नहीं दी जाती. सो सच डिविडेंड्स विल नॉट बी टेकन इन टू अकाउंट. नहीं दिया किसी साल तो नहीं दिया. क्यूमुलेटिव के केस में क्या होता है, इवन इफ नो डिविडेंड इज अनाउंस दैट ईयर, the company will have to make payment of the dividend in case of cumulative preference shares. I hope ye aapko samajh aa gaya. And then we have perpetual debt instruments. So these are again debt instruments, but that will go on for infinity or for perpetuity. So ye sare instruments hai, apart from them, any other securities as specified by SEBI, the Securities Exchange Board of India. So all of these securities encompasses non-convertible securities as per SEBI regulation of issue and disclosure of non-convertible securities regulation 2021. Now since these two terms are clear to you, now the news is pretty simple, very simple in fact, which says that SEBI had come up or had observed that there was a mismatch or a distorted information that was available that was displayed on the exchange website. So, jabhi bhi koi bhi over-the-counter trade ho rahe the, specifically for listed non-convertible securities, the participants were not listing or not giving the accurate information, and therefore SEBI has observed that there were incomplete and inaccurate or distorted information that was listed or displayed on the exchange website. So, in order to address this issue, SEBI has now come up with a uniform guideline or a uniform format for reporting all kinds of over-the-counter trades specifically for listed non-convertible securities. And this new uniform format will be applicable from January 1, 2023. So next year, January 1 se ye applicable hona shuru ho jayenge. Now what all are included under this uniform format? So there are certain items that needs to be reported to the exchanges for any kind of over-the-counter trades. These are items such as the type of deal that the over-the-counter trade is taking place. Is it a brokered deal through a broker or a dealer, or is it a direct deal between two participants coming together and making a deal? So you need to tell the type of the deal as well as the ISIN number, the International Security Identification number. उसके अलावा क्या वो सिक्योरिटी लिस्टेड है, नॉन लिस्टेड है, अनलिस्टेड है, द इशूअर नेम हु हैज इशूड सच सिक्योरिटीज, द कूपन रेट दैट इज एप्लीकेबल टू सच सिक्योरिटीज, एनी काइंड ऑफ इशू डिस्क्रिप्शन, द ट्रेडेड प्राइस, द यील्ड, द टाइम, द ट्रेड टाइम, द सेटलमेंट टाइम. सो ऑल ऑफ दीज इंफॉर्मेशंस, नाउ अगेन दिस इज नॉट इंपॉर्टेंट टू बी रिमेंबर्ड, बस आपको समझना है कि जितनी भी इंफॉर्मेशंस हैं रिगार्डिंग दैट ट्रेड और दैट डील अंडर द ओटीसी नीड्स टू बी रिपोर्टेड अंडर दिस यूनिफॉर्म फॉर्मैट. सो दिस वॉज द न्यूज एंड दिस विल बी एप्लीकेबल फ्रॉम January 1, 2023. मूविंग फॉरवर्ड टू द नेक्स्ट न्यूज. The next news, we have sort of talked about this news in the month of May. But फिर से ये news आया है, so let's talk about this. This is basically about the continuation of interest subvention scheme on किसान credit card, specifically for crop loans. तो अगर हम scheme की बात करें, then according to this scheme, the government has approved the continuation of the modified interest subvention scheme. अब interest subvention scheme क्या होता है? So as we all know that the small farmers, the marginal farmers, find it very difficult to take loans from the formal lending institutions, the formal credit sources, and thereby they resort to the private players or the private participants who charge them exorbitant rate of interest. So in order to encourage these farmers, these marginal small farmers to take loans from the financial institutions, from these lending institutions, they are given a minimal rate or a subsidized rate so that they are attracted to take loans under the Kisan credit card scheme. Iske andar aap loan le sakte ho as a farmer. Now If you see from the farmer's point of view, then he is at the benefit because he will be getting the loan at a subsidized rate. But what about the banks, the financial institutions? They will be at loss. For example, if they are making any kind of loan, for example, retail loan, lelo, they're making that loan for around 8.5%, 9%. But to these financial institutions, RBI or the government is saying that these financial institutions should make or should extend the loans to the farmers at subsidized rate, let's say around 7%. So there is a loss of around 1.5%. Now this subsidy that the central government has given will be subsidized to the financial institutions. Matlab, farmers banks ke paas aayenge, banks will be giving them or charging interest at the rate of 7%. Over and above जो 1.5% है, अगर 8.5% is the market rate जो चल रहा है loans पे, तो 1.5% है, this percentage will be borne by the government and the government will be making this percent or this proportion of money, will be giving this money to the commercial banks, to the banks, so that they are not in any kind of losses. तो lending institutions को दे दी जाएगी, and this is the entire concept of इंटरेस्ट सबवेंशन. सबवेंशन का मतलब होता है सब्सिडी प्रोवाइड करना, अ काइंड ऑफ सब्सिडी. सो रिसेंटली द गवर्नमेंट हैज अप्रूव्ड कि ये कंटिन्यू किया जाएगा फॉर द फाइनेंशियल ईयर 2022-23 एंड 23-24. नाउ इंटरेस्ट सबवेंशन किसको दिया जाएगा? सो दिस विल बी गिवन टू द लेंडिंग इंस्टीट्यूशन सच एज ऑल काइंड ऑफ पब्लिक सेक्टर बैंक्स, द प्राइवेट सेक्टर बैंक्स, even the small finance banks, when we have the computerized primary agricultural cooperative societies. So all those primary cooperative societies who are computerized, they are also eligible to act as a lending institution who will provide loans to the farmers. Then we also have all kinds of PSAs who are incorporated with the scheduled commercial banks and making use of their own resources. So these will be the eligible institutions, lending institutions. अगर मैं आपसे पूछूं क्या payment banks भी included होंगे इसमें? नहीं, because payment banks do not provide any kind of credit. They are not a lending institution. Definition आपको याद होना पड़ेगा यहाँ पे. So I hope lending institutions are clear to you. Now let's talk about कि ये lending institutions किस लिए loan provide करेंगे. So there are two purpose for which these lending institutions are to provide the loans to the farmers. They are to provide short-term loans, that too for crop. So they will provide short-term crop loans as well as short-term loans for allied activities. Agriculture से related जो activities होती हैं, for example, animal husbandry, fisheries, then we have beekeeping, dairy, so all of these allied activities, इनके लिए short-term loans provide किए जाएंगे. What are short-term loans? Loans that is extended only up to 1 year, that do not go beyond 1 year, is known as a short-term loan. ठीक है? And what is the maximum limit that a bank will be providing a loan? So to each individual farmer, the lending institution can make short-term crop loans or short-term allied activities loans up to an overall limit of 3 lakhs through the Kisan credit card at the concessional interest rate. जो बाकी का rate होगा वो the government will be bearing it. ये आपको समझ आ गया? This limit becomes important to be remembered from exam point of view और directly questions आते हैं. अगर आप PO exams उठाओ वहाँ पर directly पूछा जाता है. ठीक है? तो I hope the amount is clear to you. So the lending institutions can provide short-term crop loans or short-term allied activities loan up to an overall limit of 3 lakhs. In dono ko mila ke, crop or allied activities ko mila ke, 3 lakh tak aap loan de sakte ho. Now moving forward and talking about what else do we have here. Now it says that how is the interest subvention is to be calculated? The government, which is going to provide interest subvention to the lending financial institutions, will calculate the amount of interest subvention from the period the loan is given till the period the loan is repaid by the farmer or the last date that is specified by the lending institution, whichever is earlier. Agar 6 mahine ka loan hai, January 1 is the date on which the lending institution has given the loan, and this loan is to end by June 30. ठीक है? Now the interest subvention will be given for this period, the date on which the loan was disbursed to the farmer, that is January 1, and the date on which, or the date that the due date for the loan that is fixed by the bank. If suppose the farmer repays the loan in May, agar wo May 25 ko pay kar deta hai, in that case, the interest subvention, the interest that the government will bear, will be given for a time period between January 1 to May. So whichever is earlier ka concept yahan pe aa jayega, the last date fixed by the bank or the date on which the actual repayment is done by the farmer, whichever is earlier. I hope this is clear to you. Aur yahan pe short term loans hai, humne jab baat kari thi, therefore the maximum period will be just 1 year. Now let's talk about the applicable lending rates. So the farmers will be giving or providing loans to the farmers. Sorry, the lending institutions will be giving or providing loans to the farmer at the rate of 7% for 2022-23 and as well as 2023-24. Dono saal ke liye 7% pe loan provide karenge. And what is the amount of interest subvention, the subsidy that the government will be providing to these lending institutions, to these banks and NBFCs, cooperative societies, the rate will be 1.5%. So banks ko ya fir lending institutions ko loss nahi hoga, it will be taken up by the government. Ye samajh aa gaya? Now again in this very example, jahan pe humne ye baat kari ki January 1 ko loan disperse kiya gaya hai and June 30 is the last date fixed by the banks or the lending institution. If suppose again the farmer repays the loan in the month of May, jaise humne baat kari thi, that means the farmer has made a prepayment of the loan, matlab time se pehle hi pay kar diya. If the farmer repays the loan in time, then in that case the farmer is eligible to get an additional interest subvention. What is the additional interest rate subvention? It is at the rate of 3% per annum. So ye jo 7% rate of interest banks charge kar rahi thi, unko yahan pe 3% aur ki subsidy mil jayegi, and therefore the banks or the farmers will now, if they are making the payment on time or before time, in that case the farmers will effectively will have to pay just 4% per annum on the loans taken by them. The short term loans jo bhi liya jayega us pe just 4% pay karna hai. This is to incentivize the farmers to make the payment on time. I hope this is clear to you. Moving forward, और यही चीज यहाँ पे लिखा हुआ है, यू कैन गो थ्रू दिस स्लाइड. आई हैव प्रोवाइडेड ऑल द डिटेल्स हियर, इफ यू रीड इट एवरीथिंग विल बी क्लियर टू यू. नाउ मूविंग फॉरवर्ड टू द ओवरऑल लिमिट. तो हमने फर्स्ट स्लाइड में ही ये डिसाइड किया था, ये रीड किया था, दैट द लैंडिंग इंस्टीट्यूशन विल बी प्रोवाइडिंग द लोन अप टू एन ओवरऑल लिमिट ऑफ रुपीज 3 लैक्स पर एनम. एक फार्मर को 3 लैक्स पर एनम की लोन दी जा सकती है. इन दिस 3 लैक्स विल बी गिवन अक्रॉस टू थिंग्स, शॉर्ट टर्म क्रॉप लोन्स एंड शॉर्ट टर्म अलाइड एक्टिविटीज लोन. इफ सपोज अ फार्मर इज जस्ट एंगेज इन अलाइड एक्टिविटीज, ही इज एंगेज इन टू डेयरी और एनिमल हस्बेंड्री और जस्ट बी कीपिंग और फिशरी, इन दैट केस the maximum limit will now be just 2 lakhs. So 2 lakhs will be the limit. 2 lakh ki hi limit hogi, right? So 2 lakh is the maximum that a farmer will be getting loan if he is just engaged in allied activities. If suppose the farmer is engaged in both crop loans as well as allied activities, crop loans wo 4 lakh ki loan lene aaya और एलाइड एक्टिविटीज के लिए 2 लाख के लिए लोन लेने आया. हाउएवर द ओवरऑल लिमिट कितनी है हमारी, द ओवरऑल लिमिट इज 3 लैक्स. इन दैट केस द प्रेफरेंस और द प्रायोरिटी विल बी गिवन टू दिस क्रॉप लोन्स. तो सबसे पहले अगर यहाँ पे 4 लाख है तो 3 लाख इसको क्रॉप लोन्स के अंदर मिलेगी एंड फॉर एलाइड एक्टिविटीज ही विल नॉट बी गेटिंग एनीथिंग. सिमिलरली इफ आई से दैट अगर इस 4 लाख की जगह पे इफ ही he has come to take a loan for crop loans at the rate of, let's say, 2.5 lakhs. अगर उसको 2.5 lakhs की loan चाहिए Over limit is 3 lakhs. So 2.5 lakhs will be given on the crop loan and 50,000 loan can be given under this allied activities. I hope ye samajh aa gaya hoga. Please, again, listen to this, whatever I have said twice, so that it is clear to you. It's very simple. It's just that the priority is to be given to the crop loans. If the farmer comes to take loans under both the category, the overall limit is 3 lakh. उससे ऊपर आप लोन नहीं दोगे फार्मर्स को अंडर द मॉडिफाइड इंटरेस्ट सबवेंशन स्कीम. सो सिंस दिस इज क्लियर टू यू, नाउ लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द रेस्ट पॉइंट, द लास्ट पॉइंट विच सेज दैट इन ऑर्डर टू मेक इट हैसल फ्री एंड कन्वीनियंट फॉर द फार्मर्स, ऑल फार्मर्स आर रिक्वायर्ड टू हैव देयर आधार कार्ड लिंक्ड टू द किसान क्रेडिट कार्ड. सो इट इज मेड मैंडेटरी फॉर देम. अगेन वेरी सिंपल. Now let's move forward and talk about the third news. Again, this is also very, 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 very important because it talks about microfinance institutions or the microfinancials who provide micro loans to the consumers, to the people, especially in the rural areas. The rural areas mein jo log hain, unko jo loan diya jata hai, uski baat ki ja rahi hai yahan pe, right? So let's talk about what does it says. It says that the micro ventures or the micro lenders has ventured into secured loans. So let's talk about this again. So it says that recently few micro financiers have ventured into secured loans. So isko samajhne se pehle aapko piche ki history samajhni padegi. Uske liye we need to first understand the direction that has been issued by RBI for the micro financing or micro lending done by institutions. So let's talk about this under this very directions. So these directions were issued in 2022 and it is known as a regulatory framework for microfinance loans. Iske andar let's first talk about the applicability. If we talk about the applicability, who all are eligible to provide micro loans to the consumers? Consumers yahan pe kon honge? The small and the marginalized people, the rural people, the unserved and the underserved population of our country. So these are the institutions, the financial institutions that can provide loans to these, that can provide micro loans to such target consumer segment. These are first and foremost the all types of commercial banks, including small finance banks, local area banks, regional rural banks. However, we have excluded payment banks again with the for the very concept that payment banks are not a type of lending banks. They can only accept deposits, but they cannot extend any kind of loans. Again, the second point says that all kinds of primary urban cooperative banks, state cooperative banks, and district central cooperative banks are also eligible to provide micro loans. Uske baad aata hai all NBFCs, non-bank finance companies, including the microfinance institutions and housing finance companies. Ye point bahut important ho jata hai because even the housing finance companies are eligible to provide micro loans. Chote loans jo hote hain, small amount loans, this can be provided by these institutions. So this applicability becomes very, very important for you to remember for your exam. Moving forward and talking about what is this microfinance loan. Microfinance loan hota kya hai? So these are very small loans that are provided to the targeted segment, that is the unserved and the underserved segment. And it says that you provide them loans without any collateral. Aapne grameen word suna hoga kai baar, right? जहाँ पे लोग एक दूसरे में ही चिट फंड्स टाइप के थिंग होते हैं, पीपल कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट एंड दे पे लोन टू ए पर्सन विदाउट आस्किंग फॉर एनी कोलैटरल एंड द पर्सन अगेन रीपेज बैक व्हेनेवर ही हैज द मनी. सेम इज द कंसेप्ट विद माइक्रो फाइनेंस लोन, वेयर बाय अ माइक्रो फाइनेंस लोन इज प्रोवाइडेड विदाउट एनी काइंड ऑफ कोलैटरल. So the person need not give any kind of collateral नहीं देना. There is just one eligibility criteria. The eligibility criteria is that the loan is given based on an assessment of the household income, not just of that person, but the household, whereby the household includes the individual family, one individual family unit, that is the husband, the wife, and their unmarried children. So this will encompass a household. And if this household has an annual income of up to rupees 3 lakh, 50,000, 1 lakh, 1.5 lakh, up to rupees 3 lakh. So 3 lakh is the maximum limit. If any household has income up to rupees 3 lakhs per annum, then he is eligible to get a microfinance loan whereby he is not required to keep anything as collateral. So this is a collateral free loan. ठीक है, तो इसका क्या मतलब हुआ, क्या लोन हाउसहोल्ड के नाम पे होगा? नो, द लोन विल बी अगेंस्ट द नेम ऑफ दैट पर्सन. सपोज अगर हस्बैंड जा रहा लेने, इट विल बी इन द नेम ऑफ द हस्बैंड ओनली, बट दिस इज जस्ट ए क्राइटेरिया टू अंडरस्टैंड द हाउसहोल्ड इनकम ऑफ दैट फैमिली. ठीक है, सो अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट व्हाट एल्स इज दैट. सो नेक्स्ट इट सेज दैट इच रेगुलेटेड एंटिटी, आरई, हमने बहुत बार पढ़ा है, the applicable financial institutions are known as RE here. So each regulated entity should create their own board approved, uski jo board of directors hone chahiye, they should create a board approved policy regarding how much interest payment is to be taken from such a family. If we talk about here 3 lakh, if 3 lakh is the annual income of a family, that means monthly income uski kitni hogi, monthly income would be around 25,000. So 25,000 is the monthly income. In that case, a maximum 12,500, 50% would be 12,500. Only 50% should be asked as an outflow or as a interest payment or the borrowing. So loan obligation kitna hona chahiye on this household? So the loan obligation on this household should be a maximum of 50%, not more than that. In that case, only a maximum of 12,500 should be asked as loan obligation from such a family. If suppose this family has taken some other loans as well, in that case, cumulatively, his total monthly obligation should not exceed 50% of his monthly income, monthly household income. So this is what it has been explained here. Let's move forward and talk about other things, that is penalty. Will a penalty be charged? So if the household repays the money on time or before time, then there is no prepayment penalty. If suppose the person has taken this microfinance loan for 6 months and he repays that in 3 months, in that case, no prepayment penalty is to be charged. Apart from that, if he delays the payment, 6 mahine mein karni thi, he delays it by 1 month, let's say he makes a payment in 7th month, in that case, penalty is to be charged only for that 1 month jahan se usne delay kiya hai, and not for the entire 7 months, right? And this is what it says, that the delayed amount, if he delays the payment, in that case the penalty will be applied only over on the overdue amount and not on the entire loan amount. इंटरेस्ट पेमेंट करनी थी, सपोज 6 months के लिए था, 5 months तक ही मेक द पेमेंट ऑन टाइम, बट द 6 month ही कुड नॉट मेक द पेमेंट, सो पेनल्टी विल बी चार्ज ओनली ऑन दिस ईएमआई पार्ट, दैट पेमेंट दैट ही हैड टू मेक ऑन द 6th month एंड नॉट फॉर द रेस्ट ऑफ द पेमेंट दैट ही हैज मेड ऑन टाइम. सो दिस इज एन इम्पॉर्टेंट फीचर ऑफ माइक्रो फाइनेंस लोन्स. And then comes the minimum requirement of microfinance loan. So yahan pe aapko ek baat samajhna padega, that under the NBFCs we have a separate kind of institution known as NBFC microfinance institutions. Now for these institutions that are specifically meant to provide loans to these to provide microfinance loans to the unserved and the underserved population, to the poorer section of our society, these microfinance institutions should provide a minimum of 75% of their total assets as microfinance loans. However, for all other kinds of NBFCs apart from this MFIs, they can provide a maximum of 25% of the total assets as microfinance loans. I hope aapko yahan pe samajh aa gaya. Agar hum specifically MFIs ki baat kare, microfinance institutions, if 100 rupees is the total assets that they have, then out of this 100 rupees, maximum 75% or 75 rupees should be allotted to providing microfinance loans, and the rest 25% can be made to other types of loan. Microfinance loans ka kya matlab hua? Collateral free loan. This is collateral free. Here, the rest 25% can be made use to make loans which involve certain kind of collateral. Ya isko hum bol sakte hain secured loan de sakte hain ye. right? So they can provide secured loans up to a maximum of 25%. Earlier, the limit was 15%. I hope आपको समझ आ गया. We talk about NBFCs, इनके केस में opposite है. Maximum जो उनका unsecured या microfinance loans कितना होगा, that is collateral fee that will be 25%, and the rest 75% should be made use to make secured loans that involves collateral. I hope again this is clear to you. Moving forward to the net owned fund criteria. Now why I'm discussing all of these points is that microfinance institutions are very very important from your exam perspective. क्योंकि बहुत ही इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक बन जाता है, बीट सेबी, बीट आरबीआई स्पेसिफिकली, तो आपको सारे पॉइंट्स आने चाहिए. नेक्स्ट इज द नेट ओन फंड. सो देर वॉज अ ग्लाइडिंग पाथ दैट वॉज डिसाइडेड फॉर दिस नेट ओन फंड. नेट ओन फंड क्या होता है? द टोटल ऑफ योर शेयर होल्डर्स कैपिटल, देन योर रिजर्व्स, एनी काइंड ऑफ प्रीमियम्स एंड रिजर्व्स इन सरप्लस, माइनस एनी काइंड ऑफ रीवैल्यूएशन लॉसेस. Your total capital of your company could be said as the net owned fund, and that at present is around 5 crores. The requirement is that such microfinance institutions should have 5 crores as the minimum net owned fund. However, they are required that by 31st March 2025 that should be increased to 7 crore, and by 2027 that should increase to 10 crores. So net own fund of microfinance institutions, specifically MFIs, should increase to 10 crores by 31st March 2027. Now, since this is clear to you, now let's talk about the news. News kya tha? News was very simple. The news said that now these microfinance institutions, the microfinancers, are stepping or venturing into providing secured loans. As we have talked about, 75% should be given as collateral free loans under microfinance loans. Rest 25% are now being utilized by these micro lenders, the microfinancers, in order to provide secured loans whereby a collateral will be provided by the borrower. Why are they doing this? Now, if you have your total balance sheet, agar aapka total balance sheet aisa hai ki wahan pe koi collateral nahi hai, and if the person defaults, then you don't have anything. But if certain percentage of the loan that you are providing is based on certain collateral, even if the person defaults, if the borrower defaults, you have that collateral which you can sell and then recover the money from that collateral. So this 25% will provide as an extra cushion for this microfinance institutions, and that is the reason why that this step has been taken by the microfinancers, and this step has been taken after RBI allowed these microfinance institutions to lend 25% of the total assets in non-microfinance loans that involves collateral. And we talk about an example, then this Credit Access Grameen, which is a Bengaluru-based microfinance institution, has indulged into providing secured loans, that is non-microfinance loans that involves collateral, specifically into these three sectors, mortgages, gold and two-wheeler loans. Again, this amount figure is not important from your exam point of view. I hope aapko samajh aa gaya hoga. I know the session was lengthy today because we had three very important news articles. These were lengthy as well. But yes, this will be rewarding for you if you understood it very well. Be it the microfinance institutions or the interest subvention scheme. These are very, very, very important news article. And now let's move forward to the questions. So moving forward to the first question for today that we have, the question says, recently, that is in the month of November, SEBI has come up with a uniform format for reporting dash trades in dash, as it was observed that incorrect and distorted information were displayed on the exchange's website. So, iske aapko answers batane hain. Again, this is very simple. Moving forward to the next question. The question says, which of the following is not a part of non-convertible securities as per SEBI regulation of 2021? So this again we have discussed. Maine aapko har ek point ko explain kiya tha. You need to link through that and answer this question in the comment section. Moving forward to the third question, which says, which of the following is correct? True, right? Correct statements aapko nikalne hai regarding the modified interest subvention scheme. First statement says the interest subvention will be provided to the lending institutions such as public sector banks, private banks, small finance banks, RRBs, payment banks, etc. Second, in order to avail the interest subvention, eligible lending institutions will have to provide short-term crop loans and short-term loans for allied activities up to an overall limit of 3 lakhs to farmers through Kisan Credit Card at concessional interest rates during the years 2022-23 and 23-24. Now, lamba sentence hai, but we have talked about this and very simple to remember and answer. The third statement says the rate of interest subvention that will be given to lending institution for the financial year 2022-23 is 2%. हमने डिस्कस किया था द टेबल जहां पे हमने लेंडिंग इंस्टीट्यूशन को कितना सबमेंशन मिलेगा. वी टॉक्ड अबाउट देयर. सो यू नीड टू आइडेंटिफाई द करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट्स. नाउ मूविंग फॉरवर्ड टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चंस. अगेन वी हैव मोर क्वेश्चंस फॉर टुडे. वी हैव 7 क्वेश्चंस. द फोर्थ क्वेश्चन ऑन द स्क्रीन सेज व्हाट इज द एडिशनल इंटरेस्ट सबमेंशन दैट इज प्रोवाइडेड टू द एलिजिबल फार्मर्स अंडर द मिस इफ सच फार्मर्स रीपे द लोन इन टाइम. We talked about this ki additional interest subvention milega. You need to tell me the percentage. Next, the question says according to RBI's regulatory framework for microfinance loans direction 2022, which of the following financial institutions are allowed to extend microfinance loans? Kaun kaun provide kar sakte hain? We have all scheduled commercial banks, small finance banks, payment bank, local area banks, all primary urban cooperative banks, NBFCs and housing finance companies. Again, very simple question, kyunki humne isko discuss kiya hai. Moving forward to the next question, which says, what should be the maximum annual household income in order to be eligible for a microfinance loan? Kisko microfinance loan di ja sakti hai? We have talked about household income is the eligibility criteria. And again, this is very simple. Answer it in the comment section. And lastly, the last question for today, which says, what is the minimum requirement of microfinance loans for NBFC, microfinance institutions, as per RBI's regulatory framework, directions 2022. So, aapko minimum requirement batane hai. Is it 25%, 50%, 75%, 85% or 90% of the total assets? Again, the answers are provided in the PDF. In case you, if you have any doubt, then you can write it down in the comment section. If you are an enrolled student, make use of the discussion forum and post all your doubts, all your queries out there. Also, if you have any feedback for us, please feel free to reach out on this number. The number is 9999466225. You can provide be it a negative feedback or a positive feedback upon the way we teach, the content that we provide, and anything or everything that is related to whatever is delivered to you. And keep learning. This is all from my side for today. Thank you. Bye-bye.